viability of the amniotic membrane in several solutions. Authors Suraji L. H. H., Adhikari A. A. P., Vijayaratna S. M., De Silva M. V. C., Ranaveera G. C. Paper will be presented by Suraji L. H. H., Research Assistant, Department of Surgery, Faculty of Medicine, University of Colombo.
Good morning, everyone. So my research is about the viability of the amniotic membrane in several solutions. I'm Hiranya. As an introduction, the human amniotic membrane, as we all know, is the innermost thickest layer of the fetal membrane, in which the thickness ranges from 0.02 millimeters to 0.5 millimeter, and it is composed of five histological layers, namely the epithelium, basement membrane, compact layer, fibroblast layer, and the spongy layer. It also contains several compounds that makes it as a natural wound dressing. But the main problem we face when it is used as a wound dressing is that it has a low cell viability. So even in literature, although it is said that it has a ranging viability from 48 hours to 6 weeks, it also depends on the preservative method that we use. So this shows the layers of the fetal membranes. So the main objective of the study was to develop a method to increase the rate of wound healing using amniotic membranes collected from the freely consenting mothers. And our specific objective was to study the viability of the amniotic membrane, epithelial cells, and basement membranes up to 7 days in the solutions normal saline, Hartmann, third-person glycerol solution, and HTK solution. So for that, we used the following study procedure. We obtained placenta from freely consenting mothers who are undergoing cesarean section. And after that, we separated the cori amniotic membrane together. And then by using the blunt dissection, we separated the amniotic membrane. Then this amniotic membrane was washed with saline solution to which the gentamicin was added until all blood was cleaned out. Then the equal pieces of amniotic membrane were added to labeled glass bottles containing formaldehyde solution, normal saline solution, wrinkle lactate, 30% glycerol, and HTK solution separately. And then the formaldehyde stored amniotic membrane was used to study the normal morphology of the fresh amniotic membrane. Rest of the solutions we stored at 4 degrees Celsius. So a tissue sample was obtained from each solution, and it was fixed in formaldehyde 24-hour time interval for 1 week. And then two separate tissue samples were taken, and two separate slide preparations were done with HNE staining and PAS staining. And then we examined the viability by using the following criteria. We studied for the percentage of normal morphology of the cells and basement membrane, and also the degenerative changes and the complete loss of the epithelial cells or either basement membrane. So these are my results. When studying the morphology of the fresh amniotic membrane, the HNE stain slice showed it is composed of a single layer of epithelial cells and an avascular stromal cell layer. In between, it is not distinct in HNE actually. So in PAS staining, we can see the basement membrane just underneath the single layer of epithelial cells. And this show, moving on to the viability of the cells in the several solutions, we observed that in normal saline solution, the cell viability varies from 5% to 8%. And this figure shows the best preserved cells morphology. And basement membrane viability was ranging from 20% to 90%. In cells, we saw vacuolar formation in the cytoplasm and loss of the normal integrity of the nucleus. But in wrinkle lactate solution, we saw the cell viability is ranging on from 10% to 40%, and basement membrane viability was ranging from 5% to 40%. So especially in ringer lactase solution, we observed that in some areas, the basement membrane was separated from the single cell layer of epithelial cells. In contrast, in 30% glycerol solution, we observed that the cell viability is ranging from 40% to 80%, and the basement membrane viability is ranging from 30% to 75%. The one thing we saw was the cells were swollen in the epithelial cells, and that is also justified in the literature because glycerol is hydrophilic, so taking water that makes cells swollen. So in HTK solution, we observed cell viability is varying from 70% to 95%, and BM viability was ranging from 20% to 80% because we excluded the first day as it was not showing the continuity. So as a conclusion, we concluded that ringer lactate solution or Hartmann is not suitable to preserve human amniotic membrane, but amniotic membrane preserved in 30% glycerol solution and HTK solution could be used within 7 days. So there are several limitations in the study.
Time is up.
Okay. These are the limitations, references. Thank you.
Paper is open. Questions?
Huge, isn't it? 20 to 80%.
Sorry.
Your viability range.
Yeah. Which solution, sir?
Now here you have given us 20%, but you said it ranges from 20 to 80%. Was it your study?
Yeah, 20 to 80%. I'm not. It's not clear for me, sir.
No. Well, you have said the basement membrane was retained for 30% in saline, and for HTKs it was 20%.
Yeah.
Was it 20% or you said a range? Did I get it wrong?
So HTK, it can be preserved 80% actually.
Not 20?
20% was the least, but in normal saline, we couldn't preserve it for 80% actually. And I consider the range of viability. So HTK, I observed 20 to 80%.
So that is what I asked. So that's a huge range.
Yeah.
So why do you think that range is so huge?
It's maybe the degenerative changes are taking time to appear because we only did the microscopic examinations. That's a limitation, actually.
So do you think you can draw up a conclusion when the range is so huge?
Depending on these findings, we drew a conclusion because cell viability was better in HTK solution. We observed the best cell viability in HTK solution and glycerol. And glycerol is proved to be used in the literature also. They are using glycerol, but different concentration and different temperature. So HTK showed the best cell viability. That's why we chose.
So there's a difference between basement membrane preservation and the...
Yeah, but when we consider the cell viability, best is preserved in 95% at day 6. And at day 6, basement membrane is also preserved 40%. So that combination is there in HTK, but not in other solutions. That was the reason for selecting HTK.
So what is the surgical requirement actually? How soon they want? Do they want to have it after
actually,
1 week?
Actually, we were doing a pilot study, putting amniotic membrane in chronic wounds. So we faced the difficulty of keeping amniotic membranes for a long time because the viability is very low. So at least for 1 week, if we can keep it, we can put it into patients. Otherwise, it's a long process that we have to clean again. And if we can collect amnion at one time, and if we can store them, we can take a maximum use, sir. That was the reason we conducted this.